Yo me llamo Tarzán y la gente me dice, ¿cómo es?
El rey de la selva.
Mary Jane es perfecta gracias a sus raíces.
¿Sabes
cómo es?
El rey de la selva.
Ando con mis leones cazando los ciervos. ¿Cómo es?
El rey de la selva.
Yo soy el efecto de leones a cerdos. ¿Cómo es?
El rey de la selva.
Hello Tarzán, hello Tarzán. Soy el mero, pero haters no faltan. Yo le echo los leones.
So this video is going to be a DIY of how to make a bell sleeve attached to the top that I shared with you last week. So if you have not yet made this top, go ahead, make the top before and come back here later after you have finished your top, and then you can add the sleeve. I made the sleeve and measure 16 inches. I just show you before, and now I'm just gonna show you how to do the other side. First of all, you need your top to be in the right side and at the back. I like to start the sleeve always around, you know, the back, and you know, just at the back in the corner or under the armpit. In this case, it's like in the corner there. So you're just gonna slip knot and make two chain, and these two chain just to build up the yarn. You're not counting anything yet, and now you start to count by adding half double crochet across. So the way I do is that when it's a big hole like that area, I always add two half double crochet there, and then you see the stitch like this. That's like a V shape. You're gonna have the space in the between. I add one half double crochet there. So this is what I do you know, on the yoke part on this sleeve in round one. So I'm just gonna add two half double crochet where I have bigger space, and one half double crochet where I have like smaller space. The thing is, you need to have in this round one the multiple of 4 plus 3. So for me, I'm going to make the same like in my first sleeve, which is 71, and 71 is the multiple of 4 plus 3. And one more thing, when you come to the underarm, like where I am right now, you're gonna see something like there's no stitch. You just have to poke the hook in kind of like in between, and it's gonna be self-explained when you are there. You're just gonna poke the hook where you can, and this way it's gonna come out nicely. So here I am at the end of the round. I have made 70 half double crochet, so I need one more stitch. I'm just gonna add my last stitch into where I slip knot, because that chain 2 doesn't count. There is no slip stitch at the end of the round and no beginning chain for round 2 as well. As you can see, I already add one double crochet into the next stitch, which is the first stitch of round 1. I skip 2 stitches and I add chain stitch into the next stitch, and the chain stitch is a combination of 2 double crochet chain 3, 2 double crochet in one stitch. This is pretty much the design of the yoke area. And now you're going to skip 3 half double crochet or 3 stitches and add chain stitch into the next one. Again, the chain stitch is the same thing, 2 double crochet chain 3, 2 double crochet, and this is just going to be the repeat of this round. So from now on, you're going to always skip 3 chain. It's just only on the beginning that you skip 2 chain. Just it has to be that way for the number to work out. But now from now on, the design, the pattern, just start from here to skip 3 stitches or 3 half double crochet from previous round and add the chain stitch into the next one. 2 double crochet chain 3, 2 double crochet is the chain stitch that we use for this design, and go ahead, repeat this until the end of the round. At the end of the round, you see that you have 3 half double crochet left or 3 stitch left. You're just gonna skip 2 half double crochet and add one double crochet at the last stitch. And this is how you end your round two. And for round three, we're going to add double crochet into the next double crochet. So you have the double crochet at the beginning from round two. And now you're just gonna add shell stitch into that chain three loop. And the shell stitch, what is that? Two double crochet, chain three, two double crochet. And this round three is just so easy. It's easier than round two because you're just gonna add shell stitch in every chain three loop, around and across until the end of the round. You will finish this round by adding one double crochet into that last double crochet from previous round, and you see that at the beginning you have one double crochet and at the end as well. You may want to add stitch marker, but for me, I'm fine with that. And now you're just gonna repeat round three for the pattern. So go ahead, make as many rounds as you need. And at the last round, after the shell stitch made the last set, in that double crochet stitch, you're going to add single crochet there to close the circle. This way is gonna be the same level. And then you're just gonna slip stitch into the next one, chain one, and cut the yarn. This is how I did my last round, and I have made a total of 25 rounds. And you're done! I hope you enjoyed this short video tutorial and learn how to make this cute bell sleeves to add with this top, this Aurora off the shoulder top. Let me know in the comment below if you enjoy this video tutorial, and I'm going to announce the winner of the pattern giveaway now. If you like this video, give a big thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, and click that little bell next to it as well. And see you next time. Bye bye. Yo le echo los leones y ya está.